Hey guys, and welcome to Charged Up News, a weekly roundup of EV stories from around the globe. Today's show will include the Kia e-Niro launch at the 2018 Paris Auto Show, the newest offering from Energica Motorcycles, a solid-state battery from C4V scheduled for production in early 2019, and a full-scale passenger capsule for the Hyperloop. But first up on the show, how cool are these beasts from Arcimoto? Like a cross between a snowmobile, a jet fighter and a trike, Arcimoto has developed possibly the best three-wheeler ever, and the most amazing part is the base price of just $11,900 for the 70-mile version. Classed as a motorcycle and highway legal in the US, it has a top speed of 80 miles per hour and a 0 to 60 time of 7.5 seconds, with a range of 70 or 130 miles with the 12 or 20 kilowatt hour packs. Founded in 2007 in Eugene, Oregon, Arcimoto has been through 8 prototypes, and now their beta series of fun utility vehicles, or FUVs, has officially hit the road. With their 2018 production targets being met so far, it looks like the customer versions will be available towards the end of the year. These could be so much fun around town, as well as the perfect rental vehicles for holiday locations. Robert De Niro has teamed up with Kia to launch their e-Niro electric crossover and their European debut at the Paris Motor Show.
Ta-da! Soon you'll be seeing a lot more of this Niro and that Niro. Stay tuned.
As an outspoken activist regarding climate change and a critic of the US's current lack of leadership to solve the huge problem we all face, De Niro is a great match for the zero-emissions Kia. The e-Niro, revealed in European spec, will have a mixed-use driving range of 300 miles or 485 kilometres and a city range of up to 382 miles or 615 kilometres. The new e-Niro joins existing hybrid and plug-in hybrid variants of the Niro, of which more than 200,000 have been sold since its introduction in 2016, and will be covered by a 7-year 150,000 kilometre warranty as standard. Although we don't have these yet in Australia, I caught an Uber recently, which was the locally delivered petrol version of this model, and it seemed to be a great car, with loads of passenger room in the back. In news coming out of Binghamton in New York, the company C4V has announced that they have a solid-state battery ready for production in early 2019. Their current battery has an energy density of 380 watt-hours per kilogram, which compares favourably to the Tesla Panasonic lithium cells at a rumoured 250 watt-hours per kilogram, and the company is already targeting 400 watt-hours per kilogram within the next 6 months. What this means in the real world is that a current model car with a range of 300 miles or 480 kilometres could increase that range to a potential 510 miles or 816 kilometres. While they don't mention the life expectancy of the cells, this increased range would be a real game-changer for battery electric vehicles, and range anxiety would be something more associated with fuel cars. In Tesla news, 80,142 vehicles were produced in Q3, 50% more than their prior all-time high in Q2. 55,840 of those cars were Model 3s, 14,470 were Model S's, and 13,190 were Model X's. To put that into perspective, the number of vehicles delivered in Q3 was more than 80% of all vehicles delivered in 2017. Tesla is also pushing forward with the construction of their Shanghai factory, as with the current import tariffs sitting at 40% on Tesla vehicles compared to 15% for other imported cars, and ocean transport costs, they're operating at a 55 to 60% cost disadvantage compared to locally produced cars. Also in Tesla news, John Hall, a new Model 3 owner, was pulled over for having his computer mounted on his dashboard. Now, I guess you can't blame the cop, as from some angles it does look a little bit stuck on. Here's part of the exchange.
You're not allowed to have your computer mounted on there.
Could you help me take it off?
Put it to GPS, which is kind of cool, but you're not allowed to have anything.
Oh, this, any screens like this that. Is stock with the car. Like, this literally is my only center console.
What is this thing?
It's called a Tesla Model 3.
Announced at the recent Paris car show, BMW has confirmed that the i4 will go into production in 2021. The i4 will join the new longer range i3, the Mini Electric in 2019, the iX3 in 2020, and the iNext in 2021. This will be BMW's first mainstream EV on the market, with their focus directly aimed at buyers attracted to the current Tesla offerings. With a potential range of 450 miles or 700 kilometres, buying one of BMW's petrol sedans would kind of seem pointless. I personally love the looks and I can't wait to see them on the road. In local news, premium petrol in Brisbane, my hometown here in Australia, just hit $1.90 per litre. Now, I know this is cheap in some countries, but the recent increases can do nothing but help EV sales. Using the fuel costs calculator on the website myelectriccar.com, at current petrol prices and using the most expensive electricity tariff, for us travelling 15,000 kilometres, we would have an annual savings of $2,608 if we had an electric van. But if we charged the car from solar panels on the roof, we would avoid the petrol and electricity charges, which would be roughly $4,000 per year. Now, you've probably heard of the Hyperloop concept of capsules travelling through vacuum tubes at speeds in excess of 1,000 kilometres per hour, but Hyperloop Transport Technologies is making that concept a reality. Revealing the world's first full-scale passenger Hyperloop capsule capable of transporting up to 40 people at a time, the company is well on its way to revolutionising the way that we travel. Hyperloop brings the speed of air travel down to the ground, but also allows the entire operation to be silent, emissions-free, and powered by renewables. With agreements for development in multiple countries and hundreds of millions of dollars in investment, this is one company worth keeping a close eye on. Our last story for the week comes from the Italian electric motorcycle company Energica with the release of their latest model, the Ego Sport Black. Based on the Ego Sport bike, which was selected as the electric bike of the year by Motorcycle News, the new bike is to honour the huge amount of development that the technical team is carrying out in preparation for the inaugural season of the Moto E World Cup, where Energica will be the single manufacturer. It has a 150 horsepower motor, a 0 to 100 time of 3 seconds, and a top speed of 240 kilometers per hour, making it faster than a 600cc Supersport. In 2019, the Moto E series will support the MotoGP at 5 European circuits, so it will be interesting to see how they compare to the gas bikes. So, thanks for tuning into the show. As always, if you'd like to keep up to date with the latest EV news and you're not subscribed to the channel already, then hit the red button below and I will catch you on the next one.